Hello Virgo, welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is Andrea and I'm here to do your weekly tarot reading. And it will be from the 11th to the 17th of January 2021 for the sign of Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. Okay, so your card has just fallen out. We have meditation brings answers, Virgo. It feels very much like your energy, the Hermit card in tarot, finding illumination from within in how you need to take action in your external environment. And remember, there's a great aligning energy here. You're being inspired, illuminated to align with your direction now. It feels very beautiful indeed. Okay. It might well be some of you are doing meditation as well, literally. So what do we have for Virgo, please? Angels, spirits, guides, message for Virgo for the week. Thank you. What does Virgo need to hear the most? Oh, thank you. Okay. Oh, yeah. Well, I don't really need to say any more than that, do I? I mean, pretty much what I was saying here, inner knowing, it might well be you're being told you already know the answer, you know? Or you'll find answers from within, but that is a powerful energy between those two cards. Definitely trust your own intuition, your own wisdom, your own innate feelings in a situation. Okay. And that's what you do so well, being the Hermit. It's a great energy of know thyself, you know? Okay, so I'm going to pull four cards. The first card is you, your current situation. Second card is your challenge. Third card, advice from spirit. Fourth card is your outcome. And then we get clarity and go deeper into the message, Virgo. And it won't resonate with everybody, so just take what resonates with you. Okay, so what do we have for Virgo? Thank you, two cards. So I have the Eight of Swords, and I have this with the Empress. We have the Tower in your challenge position. Ace of Cups, very nice, is advice from spirit. And the Moon energy, very intuitive, is your outcome. So I'm going to clarify the cards and go deeper into the message, Virgo. So what do we have for Virgo, please? Angel, spirits, guides, message for our lovely Virgos. Thank you. Yeah, we have the Page of Coins, earth energy, which is nice because you are an earth sign. The Tower we have with the Eight of Swords. The Ace of Cups, Virgo, is clarified with the Eight of Wands. And the Moon energy is clarified with the Seven of Wands. Bottom of the deck, oh wow, look at this, look at this. We had the Hermit, your card. I felt the Hermit card very strong in those energies. So I'm really pleased that you've appeared as a major arcana in your reading. There's a feeling here, Virgo, of being lost, feeling lost, lack of direction, things getting on top of you. That, it feels like that's a situation in your current place in this reading, because the Eight of Swords can be a feeling of a futility, can be a negative thoughts, negative feelings, you know, negative, it's Gemini Swords energy, so it can be to do with our thought patterns, our focus, our energy. There's a lack of focus with the Eight of Swords because the mind is in a negative state. It doesn't know which way to turn. It doesn't know how to move forward, you know? And it's how the mind can play tricks on us, keep us prisoner. It is a prisoner energy. And it's to do with prisoner of the mind. And the Empress is an energy of... It's an energy, it's a number three in the tarot, and it's major arcana energy, which is a creation energy, manifesting something new. She is the first signs of manifesting something new, being beginning to happen in its physical form. I mean, for some of you, I mean, she is sometimes linked with pregnancy. She can be linked with money, areas, career opportunities. She can also be linked with love, romance, relationships. So for some of you, there's a feeling of this is futile, negative thinking, something getting you down, feeling lost, lack of direction in how to manifest something new. And again, the Page of Coins is a manifesting energy. Page of Coins can be to do with just manifesting. It can be to do with sometimes skill set, developing your skill set, certainly in terms of money and career, to be more attractive in jobs, career, business. It is a great energy of developing your skill sets, your learning, your knowledge, professional qualifications. It lays the foundation for future growth, long-term growth, you know, that kind of energy. But it feels like you, whatever this Page of Pentacles is, you want to manifest some kind of opportunity, but you don't know how. Now, Page of Pentacles is very good, like I said, money, career, finances. It can be a purely manifesting energy, so it could be in terms of pregnancy. It can also be in terms of love, romance, relationships. But it's this feeling of, you know, the Pentacles is our conscious reality. It is to do with things in our tangible world. So can be to do with our money and career, can be to do with our property, can be to do with love, romance, relationships. It feels in this energy, Virgo, you've been wanting to manifest something, but it doesn't. There's this kind of like lack of focus in terms of, or lack of, it's not necessarily know-how, it's the mind, it's the mental energy, the feeling of things are futile, you know, it's the negative thinking that is almost blocking this happening for you. And the message here from Spirit is, you already have the answers from within. There's a deep inner knowing, whether you know it or not, in how you need to take action in your external environment now. So there is a powerful enlightenment, guidance, illumination, definitely shining the light from within in this situation on how you need to take action. Because again, in your challenge position, we have the Eight of Swords with the Tower. So I'm going to clarify this Tower. What do we have, please? What is this Tower for Virgo? Can we be more specific on this Tower for Virgo, please? Angel spirits guides. Thank you. Okay. So the Two of Swords, which is lack of clarity, feeling stuck. It feels in this situation, let's collect one more for this Tower. What is this Tower, please, Angel Spirits Guide? What is this Tower for Virgo? What is this Tower for Virgo, please? Okay, so we have the Queen of Coins. So, I mean, this could be you because it is a Earth energy. Generally, it's Capricorn for me as a reader. But the Queen of Swords, why do I keep on saying the Queen of Swords? Queen of, strange. The Queen of Coins, Virgo, is a card of focus, of being methodical, being patient, doing one thing at a time, steely determination, patience, perseverance, brings abundant success. Also a nurturing, healing energy. But again, it feels in this situation, I feel this is linked to this Page of Coins, wanting to manifest some kind of opportunity. It feels like you want growth, and I'm kind of getting more to do with money, career, business, because she is a growth card. She understands by her practical abilities how to bring success, abundance. She can be a working parent, you know, providing for the family or providing for herself. You know, it's that kind of energy, financially providing. So there's a feeling of not having enough. And it feels to do with money, career, finances, the fact that she's come out. And the tower is deep change in your circumstances. So the tower as a challenge position, it is a card of deep change. Now, this can be about the old being torn down. So this can be to do with changes in your jobs, your career, your business, your finances, your property even. And the lack of clarity, again, with the Two of Swords, in understanding how to make decisions to see a way forward. The message with the Two of Swords is the answers are not going to be in your external environment. The mind is not going to give you the answers. You know, seeing things the way you normally do, your normal senses, won't give you the answers. The way that will give you the answer, the direction that you need to go now, is with your intuition. And that's the Two of Swords. You make decisions based on your intuition because there's a lack of clarity in how to bring growth, maybe abundance, success into your life. And it feels to do with money and career here. And the Eight of Swords is a card of feeling the situation's futile. You know? I don't see how to move forward in this. Things are beyond my control. I mean, that tower could be the pandemic. Changes in your money, career, finances, even property due to the pandemic, maybe for some of you as well. The message with the Eight of Wands, and I love this energy because it's the shift. It's the shift that's leading to some kind of beautiful opportunity here. I'm going to clarify this Ace of Cups. Yeah, you see, I've got the Eight of Wands again, even at the bottom of this deck. So let's clarify this Ace of Cups, please. I feel like angel spirits guides are putting words in my mouth here in this reading. Literally. Okay, so we have the Six of Wands, which is a card of victory, accomplishment, a significant success, achievement by overcoming a difficult obstacle. So there's definitely an energy here. Yeah, you see, Five of Coins, feeling financial lack. So the message here, Virgo, is the Eight of Wands is a card of there's a shift coming, but it depends on the actions that you take. So the Eight of Wands can be to do with distance communication. It can be to do with online opportunity as well for me as a reader. It can be to do with certainly with that Page of Coins, if you're putting yourself out there, if you're sending your CV off, if you're connecting to like-minded people, maybe in terms of business, career, networking circles, that kind of thing. Obviously, social distancing and the pandemic provided for. There is some kind of news, good news coming your way. It can be in the form of, I mean, this sometimes for me as a reader can be a conversation leads to something solid as well. But it's bringing a shift, positive shifts in your circumstances. And it's linked to this, the Ace of Cups, which is the victory card. So the Ace of Cups with the Six of Wands, which is the victory card. Six of Wands is a significant success, having overcome a challenge and come through the other side of a situation and feeling empowered. I mean, you discovered your own power in this situation, and it feels that spirit is giving you intuitive guidance. I mean, the Ace of Cups is intuitive guidance on how you need to open a new door, how you need to take action towards this victory. So again, there's an energy of trust your intuition to find this Ace of Cups, the cup of joy, you know, the thing that you want, the thing that you want most. You're being guided to through your inner knowing. But also the Ace of Cups, yes, this can be to do with something that brings you joy, happiness, emotional happiness, something that you really want. And it feels like something that you've been wanting to manifest, but feeling the situation is futile, feeling stuck, and not seeing any growth in this situation. It definitely feels this Ace of Cups. Spirit is showing you love. You are the vessel receiving love and light from the universe. And the Ace of Cups here, Virgo, can be to do with self-love, finding a new door that brings you happiness and joy. It can be to do with love, romance, relationships, but it can also be to do with some opportunity, possibly a creative opportunity, that brings you joy, happiness. Again, some sense of victory. So there's definitely an energy here, Virgo, of you're going to come through the other side of a situation, and that's what spirit is telling you. But deep down, the answers are not out there. The way you approach this situation is blind faith, trusting your intuition, trusting your inner knowing here, because the answers, the illumination is coming from within. And again, in this energy, you are being told, shine the lamp from within. Shine the lamp. This is what you do. Do what you do best. That is the message from spirit. Reconnect to who you are. I did say know thyself at the beginning of this reading, and I'm getting that very strongly. Know thyself. Know your own strengths, your capabilities. Because the Hermit is a card of introspection, illumination from within on how you need to align and take action in your external environment. And as soon as you do that, Virgo, and there's definitely this energy, this illumination from within, there's a message with the Seven of Wands. Even though you have faced challenge, even though you felt things maybe a little bit overwhelming, this, when you shine the lamp from within, this is your opportunity to understand how to gain an advantage, get head and shoulders above the thing that seems to be against you and overcome it. This is a card of perseverance, determination, action. Because this person is on higher ground than those that oppose them. So whatever you're feeling overwhelmed by, the message is you get on higher ground by regrouping and reconnecting to who you are from within. And there's some kind of illumination from within that is telling you this is how you need to take action to bring change to your circumstances, which will ultimately end in a new path unfolding for you and some kind of significant victory, sense of achievement coming your way. I'm feeling pretty good about it, I have to say. So it's a lovely energy. Again, the moon, trust your intuition. When you don't have the clarity, the universe does. And it is guiding you through the murky waters of our emotions, through the murky waters of not being clear in a situation, to the path that you need to be on. So there's deep intuitive energy here, deep inner knowing energy here, because this is the card of hidden blessings, the moon card. Trust you're being guided, because you are. And you're being guided, and it feels in this situation to turn, it feels more to do with money, career, I have to say in this, to turn something around in your life and open this new door. Very nice energy, Virgo. Very deep energy as well. But I swear, I kept on feeling this Queen of Swords energy around you. And she is, I mean, I will say about the Queen of Swords, it's a Libran energy, which is about balance. But she is also to do with rising above the clouds of confusion and getting clarity in your situation, seeing the truth of the situation and making balanced judgment calls in how you need to move forward. She is somebody who understands, who gets clarity from trusting her intuition, because she's water and air. You know, air being to do with the mind, perceptions, thought patterns, and the water instinct, you know, very much to do with intuition. So there's definitely this energy of trusting your intuition to see, to get that clarity. And again, that's what I was feeling through this reading. Look what came out. We have Find balance. Find balance between your work, rest and play time, and you will have more energy, harmony and productivity in your life. Take a power nap. This is a card of regrouping. Shine the lamp and you'll find the illumination. You know, you'll find the direction, because for some of you, oh, I love this. Something is about to open up for you. I mean, look at that door. And I feel that this is these energies, the Ace of Cups, the new beginning. So we have the magical gateway. It takes courage and trust to venture into the unknown, yet this is where the greatest rewards are. It's time to step boldly forward without looking back. Definitely this energy of regroup, find your core, find your balance. And definitely there's some kind of illumination you're being given towards this new path that's unfolding for you. So it feels very beautiful. I hope you enjoyed the reading, Virgo. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe. I hope it's a wonderful week for you all, and I will see you next time. Thank you.